In this video, we can discuss about the formulation of tablets. In this, we will discuss in detail about the different steps in the manufacturing of tablets. Now, let's see what are the different steps. First step is pulverization or size reduction, then weighing, then mixing, granulation, compression, coating if necessary, and packing and quality control studies. Now this is a flowchart which will show a general steps of formulation of tablets. We have to take the active ingredients and we have to take the excipient and additive required for the manufacturing of the tablets, and we will mix and we will make it granules by granulation method. And after the granulation, we have to dry that one, then it will be compressed, and if it is necessary, we will provide coating and finally packaging. Now coming to the first step, pulverization. Different mills can be used for the size reduction to get uniformly sized excipients as well as active pharmaceutical ingredients. So these are some mills which are used for the size reduction. Cutters, mainly used for the fibrous and crude animals and vegetable tracks. Then revolving type of mills, used for fine grinding of abrasive materials. Then hammer mill are used for almost all tracks. And roller mills, which are used for soft material. Then attrition type of mill, which is used for soft and fibrous material. And fluid energy mills, which are used for moderately hard and friable materials. Now coming to the second step, weighing. Tracks and each excipient are weighed accurately according to the official formula or according to the master formula for a batch. So we will prepare a batch formula for separate batches, and we will accurately weigh the pharmaceutical ingredient as well as the excipient used for that batch. That will depends on how much tablets of that drug is going to be produced by that manufacturing process. Now third one is mixing. We have to mix the active pharmaceutical ingredient, diluents and binding agents, etc., very uniformly, because this stage will affect the overall content uniformity of the tablets. So we have to make sure that the active pharmaceutical ingredient is accurately or properly mixed in the total excipient used, and it should be uniformly distributed. So we can use double cone blender or V blenders, ribbon blenders and planetary mixer, etc. For large quantity of powder, we can use shell blender, double cone blender and planetary mixer. And for continuous production of granules, we can use ribbon blender and rota cable blenders. For production of mass mixers, we can use sigma blade mixers. But in industry, we will use highly speed granulators for the mixing as well as for the granulation process by using Diosna mixer, Littleford MGT and Graal mixture. Now coming to the next stage and most important stage of tablet manufacturing, that is granulation. And this granulation is performed to get an uniformly sized particles or granule. So granulation is done by different granulation method, like wet granulation method, dry granulation method or direct method, to get an uniformly particle sized granules. So this is the main difference between direct compression, dry granulation and wet granulation method. In direct compression, we will take the raw material and we will screen and we will blend. And directly we will compress and then we will pack. We are not preparing any kind of granules in direct compression. In dry granulation method, in this we will mix the raw materials in active pharmaceutical ingredients and different additives, and we will screen and we will blend, and we will make a pre-compression or compaction for the preparation of granules without adding water. or any aqueous solvents. So that's why it is known as dry granulation. So here a pre-compression stage will be there, or pre-compaction stage will be there. After that pre-compaction, we will get a solid matter and we will dry screen that one, or we will split into small particles by using different sieves by dry screening, and then we will add additives, and then we will follow the compression and we will go for the packaging. And in case of wet granulation method, the raw material like active pharmaceutical ingredient and diluent we will use, and we will make a granules by wet granulation method by wetting with an granulating agents or binding agent. Then we will perform a wet screening process. After that we will dry, and then dry screening by using another sieve, and then we will add additives like lubricants and disintegrating agent, then compression, and we will package that one. So this is the main difference. Now we will discuss in detail of each method. So first method is wet granulation method. So first step is milling of the dreg and excipient to get uniformly sized particles. After that, in step 2, we will weigh the accurate amount of active pharmaceutical ingredient and polymer which is required for that batch of manufacturing. Now third step is mixing. In this, active pharmaceutical ingredient, diluent and part of disintegrant is mixed together by using different mixers. Then as a next stage, we will produce a wet mass. So this is an important step in the wet granulation method. The amount of binders or granulating agent will make a major difference in the granule formation. So the wet massing, if it is over wetted, it will form hard granules and which may not disintegrate in the stomach. So if it is under wetted, they will form soft granules and they will not they will be powdered during the lubrication and leads to difficulty in compression. So we cannot get a tablet with the hardness. So for this we will use sigma blenders. Now wet granulation can be done by two methods. In first method, dreg and diluent is mixed, and to this we will add dry binders or dry granulating agent, and we will blend it again uniformly, and suitable solvent is added to activate the dry binders, and so that we can get a wet mass. In another method, we will mix the dreg and diluent. To this, the binder solution is added. Here, binder is added as dry powder, and then a solvent is added to mix to form a wet mass. Here we will use a binder solution to make it a wet mass by using different blenders like sigma blenders or planetary mix blenders till a properly wet mass is produced. The consistency of mass is very important. If it is too wetted, over wetted, it will stick to our hand if we are performing with our hand. And if it is under wetted, now if we are pressing that wet mass, it will powder. So in between that two, we have to keep one consistency that we can acquire by practice only. Now next step is wet screening. After the producing wet mass, we have to pass that wet mass through a sieve number of 6, 8, 10 or 12, and after that we have to dry that one in a temperature of less than 60 degrees Celsius, and the time for the drying is depends on the amount of granules. Usually in tray dryers have to dry for 24 hours. In truck dryers, the whole cabin can be taken out of the dryer, and fluidized dryer, it is the fastest method for drying. We can perform within 30 minutes. So that is the drying. After drying, we have to screen the granules again for dry screening, and we have to use different sieve size of 12 to 20, 12, 14, 16 or 20 sieve numbers to get a smaller granules with the uniform size. And then in next step, we have to lubricate these granules. We have to add 10 to 20% of fine powders which we had screened from the dry screening, and also we have to add the lubricating agents like 1.125% of lubricants, magnesium stearate like substance we have to add, and this fine powder we are adding to fill the dye cavity, also the space between the granules. So after the lubrication we will go for compression. So that is the step. We have to take the active pharmaceutical ingredients, diluents and some part of disintegrants, and by using turbular mixer we can mix it for 5 minutes. After that we have to add the fillers and again mix for 10 minutes, and by using distilled water and binding dispersion we have to granulate that one using planetary mixtures. Then by wet screening in the sieve of 12 meshes, then after drying an oven of 40 degrees Celsius or less than 60 degrees Celsius, after that again dry screening with the a sieve number of 18, and a final mixing. In that we will add Glidden lubricants and major portion of the disintegrants. After that we will go for the compression. So these are the some equipments which are used for the wet granulation method: Little Ford Logic Mixer, Diosna Mixer, Little Ford MGT Mixer, Grail Mixer, Fluid Bread Granulator Dryer, Double Core Tin Shell Blender, etc. So this is a Little Ford Logic. In this we have a chopper as well as we have a mixer to mix as well as to size reduce. So that is Little Ford Logic Mixer. This is a Diosna Mixer. In this we have a mixed bubble and high speed mixer blade, and high speed chopper is there, and a pneumatic discharge port is there, pneumatic discharge port, and a mixed lid is there which can be removed, and there is an exhaust sleeve, and mixer control panel is there. So this is the structure of Diosna mixer or Diosna granulator. This is photo of Diosna mixer. Here we have a mixer and a chopper. Now coming to Little Ford MGT mixer, is same like that of Diosna mixer. Then Grail mixer, here we have a mixing arm is there, and there is a chopper blade is there, and we have a bubble, and a bubble cover is there. Here a bubble cover is there. Then an hydraulic discharge tube is there, and that is all about Grail mixer. This is another picture of Grail mixer. Then next one is fluidized bed dryer. Here we have an provision for inlet air which is heated air and which is filtered, and we have to take the powder to be granule in here, powder bed, and to this we will add the granulating agent or binding agent, and we will flow the heated inlet air from bottom to top, and the exhaust air will be go out, and here we have a filter in order to filter these granules. So that is fluidized bed granulator dryer. Now this is a double cone or tin shell blenders. Here we have a mixer and double cone shaped vessel is there to mixer as well as for formulation of granulation. So this is another picture of double cone tin shell blender. And next one is De Nutto mixer. Here we have a mixer which will rotate in two way. It will rotate itself, and also the axle of the mixer also will rotate through the entire surface of the Dunette mixer processor. So this is another picture of De Nutto mixer processor. This is another topo granulator. Here also hair mixer is there, which will show a movement, and it will form the mixing as well as it will reduce the size of granules. Now another CF granulator.
So that is the wet granulation method. Now we will discuss about the dry granulation method. Now what is dry granulation method? It's also known as slugging or pre-compression or double compression. And mainly the drugs like aspirin and vitamins, which are more sensitive towards the moisture, are using this dry granulation method. So dry granulation method is used for the drugs which are sensitive to heat, which are sensitive to moisture, or which are sensitive to for both heat as well as moisture is done by dry granulation method, because which make impossible for the wet granulation method. And the material which should have an inherent binding or cohesive property should be used for the wet granulation method. Now these are the different steps of dry granulation method. We have to take the active substance, excipient, binding materials, etc., and we have to accurately measure the weight for each batch, and we have to mix it, and we have to perform a compaction or pre-compression. Then we have to chop it to reduce the size, and we have to sieve, and then we have to adjust the particle size, and then we can go for final compression. So milling, weighing, screening, blending, and initial compression, that is also known as slugging, and granulation by dry granulation by chopping that hard mass produced, then sieving, lubrication, and compaction. And the dry granulation method can be done by two method: by high capacity heavy duty tablet pressing, that is also known as by using slugging, and by using chillcinerator roller compactor. So there are two type of dry granulation: by using slugging, in which large tablet produces in a heavy duty tablet press; in roller compaction, a powder is squeezed between two roller to produce a sheet of material, and which is again we have to be chopped, and we have to reduce the size of granules. So in this we will use a tablet. The slugging process, we will use a tablet press, which are specially designed machinery, followed by milling and screening, so that we will get an uniformly sized particle. So in this method we will produce aspirin, which will hydrolyze it on exposure of moisture. Now second one is chillcinerator. Here we will pass the material to be compacted through a two rolls, okay, compaction rolls. So here we have an horizontal screw feed that will take the material which are placed in the hopper, and an vertical screw feed which will transfer this feed directly into the compaction rolls. So it will produce an sheet of compacted material. This sheet will be pre-breaked by pre-breakers, and again it will reduce its size by granulator, and by using different screeners, I mean sieve, we can separate the oversized granules as well as fine sized granules and desired granules. So that is the chillcinerator or roll compactor. So this is another picture. Here a horizontal feed also is a vertical feed as well. The horizontal feed will take the entire material to vertical feed, and vertical feed take the material to the compaction rolls, so that we can get a hard sheet of material. So that is chillcinerator. Advantages of dry granulation method: here we do not have to apply the moisture, so the drug which are susceptible to moisture or heat or both can be made by this granulation method. Example like calcium lactate, which cannot be done with granulation method. Also aspirin as well as vitamin can be prepared by dry granulation methods. And dry granulation method involve less step, so it will be less time consuming, so that it will be an easy method. It require less steps as well as less working space and energy when compared with the wet granulation method. Always wet granulation will be preferred, because the that will give the granules with that meet the entire physical requirement for the compression of a good tablets. Now third method is direct compression.
In this, we are not preparing any kind of granules. We are directly compressing by using directly compressible diluents like spray dried lactose. So drugs like NaCl, KCl and NaBr are used for direct compression. All the additives or excipients should have good flow property as well as stability, but the problem is maximum of 30% of active pharmaceutical ingredient can be used in direct compression methods. So the steps are milling, weighing, sieving, blending and directly compression. So what are the disadvantages? Different in particle size and bulk density between the drug and diluent, which will lead to stratification within the granulation and which will lead to poor content uniformity. So the many tablets will not meet the content uniformity test for the quality control test, and large dose of drug may be present, so it is not easily compressible by itself. So directly compressible substance may interact with the drugs, example amine compound with spray dried lactose, and it will produce some color change, yellow discoloration may be there. So that is another disadvantage. And because of dry nature of the direct compression, the static charge buildup can occur on the drug during the routine screening as well as mixing, which may prevent the uniform distribution of drug in the granulation or compression. So these are the disadvantages. Once again, we can summarize. In direct compression, we will directly compress after the screening and blending of the raw material and pharmaceutical ingredient. There is no granulation step in direct compression. But in case of dry granulation, there is a pre-compression or compaction state. And again, we have to reduce the size by dry screening, and we have to add the lubricant and a secondary compression. And in wet granulation method, we will produce a wet mass by using an aqueous solvent, and we have to wet screen and then dry screening, and after that compression. So this is a flow chart for the dry granulation method, wet granulation method and direct compaction method. So in direct compaction method, after mixing, it will directly go for compaction, but in case of dry granulation method, we have to go for a pre-compression using roller compactor, and in case of wet granulation method, we have to produce the granules by forming a wet mass, after that a drying, and after that dried granules we have to mix with the lubricant, and we have to compress that one and then tablet press, and if it is necessary we will go for coating, and we will go for the different evaluation studies of tablets. So this is all about the tablet manufacturing up to compression. In next video we will discuss about the compressions. So hope it is clear. Thank you for watching this video.